The 15th day of December 2019, we are here live at St. Andrew Anglican Church, Enugu, Nike Diocese, where they are celebrating their 2019 Diocesan 9 lesson and Christmas carol, featuring the choir. The theme, Go Tell on the Mountain, Jesus Christ is Born. It is all about Christians coming together with joy and music while celebrating the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. My name is Aniesta, reporting for Go Pack TV.
As for the Christmas carol, it's a very nice thing. As you can see, the atmosphere is already interesting. I feel so fulfilled being part of this year's Christmas carol. As you can see, the atmosphere is already, lively. The songs and all that makes me feel like I'm in heaven already. Reminds me of how heaven will be by the time we all leave. The songs and all that makes me feel like I am surrounded by the host of heavenly angels. That's how I feel.
Thank you.
Because the Lord spared our lives. There has not been too much death in this diocese this year. And we entered into a covenant with the Lord the moment we entered this Mbamunt. And the Lord has kept to his words. So I feel excited. I feel good that we are celebrating the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ.
And why are you going to tell us what it's all about?
It's all about celebrating the goodness of the Lord, the joy of the birth of the Savior of the world. And I advise people to take it easy this period. It's usually a season for everybody, everything. Wickedness, goodness, mercy is a season for everything. Let's be careful. And then trust our lives into God's care this season. And the Lord will keep us from all manner of evil.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
thousands of years later, we too would sing and be glad, accept our worship, the praise of our lips, and the thanksgiving of our hearts, when you live and reign in glory of the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Lord, we sung these carols and heard this story many times before. We confess that we have allowed the most important event in history to become known by familiarity. Help us in this act of worship to recapture a sense of wonder. Let us discover with surprise the stupendous fact that the creator of the universe has shown himself as a newborn baby. Enable us to accept what we shall never fully understand. So may our worship be filled with stupendous joy through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Ring the bells, so. Thank you.
Thank you.
God promised his faithful Abraham that in his seed shall all the nations be blessed. And the angel of the Lord called to Abraham his second time from heaven and said, by myself I have sworn, says the Lord, because you have done this and have not withheld your son, your only son, I will indeed bless you, and I will multiply your descendants as the stars of heaven, and as the sand which is on the seashore, and your descendants shall possess the gates of their enemies, and by your descendants shall all the nations of the earth bless themselves, because you have obeyed my voice. This is the word of the Lord.
Go tell it on the mount of him.
Thank you. Must be your preferred choice for sex. went to the choir of the Marine Kingdom to receive man. And you, out of the best, to extend the knowledge, went to the choir of the Marine Kingdom. And now, may our man is telling you, where is the God that has empowered you? Whatever you need, you desire in life, as only one man, I will give you, and it will be everlasting. And that is God. Is this time that you're sitting for? Seek from the house of God. Don't do what you need to do in abundance. You want to perform miracles in your ministry, God will give it to you. By selling your soul to the devil, by then, you are complicating your life. First, where you are, is it where you are supposed to be? You, the movie producer and director, what kind of things do you produce? How do you excel?
Can you start rounding up? Start rounding up, please. Please.
And Matthew, the God of God, what kind of teachings do you promote? These are the things you need to ask yourself. There is a place you can have the opportunity to serve the Lord and excel in every profession you do. That is Christian Lesbian Fellowship. It's a place anybody can belong to. When you come there, you have the opportunity to serve the Lord. And you have no fear for people like this. You have power to do anything you want to do with God. And you, the spirit of madness, I command you to leave this body right now. For this body is the temple of God. This body will be used to perform signs and wonders of God, and not for what is happening now. I command you right now to leave this body in the name of Jesus. I am not the one to forgive you. It is God that will forgive you. He says that if you leave us to talk about your sin, such life is part of the blood of
the Lord. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
If you know what dynamite means, you know when someone becomes a Shall dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the kid, and the calf and the young lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. And the cow and the bear shall feed, their young ones shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox, and the suckling child shall play on the hole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put his hand on the cockroaches. Then they shall not hurt nor destroy in all my holy mountain, for the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea. This is the word of the Lord.
Please, if you are the owner of these glasses, see me now or later with your receipt of purchase. Cathedral, Kaijena, Bethlehem.
Thank you.
Can we take the fifth lesson now, please?
Angel Gabriel salutes the Blessed Virgin Mary. Now, in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph, and of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And having come in, the angel said to her, "Rejoice, highly favored one, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women." And when she saw him, she was troubled all at his sayings, and considered what manner of greeting this was. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God will give him the throne of the father David. And he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there will be no end." Then Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I do not know a man?" And the angel answered and said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Highest will overshadow you. Therefore, also, the Holy Spirit who is to be born will be called the Holy One who is to be born will be called the Son of God. Now, indeed, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is now the sixth month for her who was called barren. For with God, nothing will be impossible." Then Mary said, "Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, let it be to me according to your word." And the angel departed from her. This is the word of the Lord.
See amid the winter snow.
Thank you.
St. Andrew's Basilica Dynamite.
down to the ground with this wicked the nations. For thou hast said in thy heart, I will ascend into heaven. I will exalt my throne above the stars of God. I will sit also upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the north. I will ascend above the heights of the cloud, and I will be like the Most High.
Lucifer, you have failed the heavens. Exile.
Who's taking this boy so long now? What if it's Namunyam appointment? My friend, what took you so long? I've been waiting for you. Please sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down. So, what about our arrangements?
These are some pictures of your fiance. You can go through them.
Oh. Where did you take this?
I was taking her at Piccadilly Hotel.
My wife in a hotel. Okay, so what do you roll? There's no problem. You've done a very good job.
I'll take care of this. In a mail for me. And let me. Okay, just help yourself. Yeah? Help yourself. Mary, hotel.
Hey,
Chineke, okay, mama, for no one. It's all right.
Joseph, there's something I need to tell you. Joseph. Joseph, what's the matter? Are you okay? What's wrong?
Where are you coming from?
I don't
have Mary, where are you coming from? It's a very simple question, no? Where are you coming from?
Why are you getting so angry? What? Joseph! What are these?
You're blind, Abby.
Joseph, are you spying on
me? Am I spying on you? Mary, who is this man? Mary, who is this man?
Joseph, calm down. Let me tell you. This is your client's friend.
No. This is what you've become.
No,
Ota Akiji is Mary.
No.
Eh?
Speak, Mary. What are you thinking?
Hi.
I just wanted to help with the business. That's all. It was supposed to be something.
Mary, I have a workshop. Mary, I have a house. You do not see anywhere to help the families in the hotel. Mary, inside a hotel, nobody can work as you could do that. Mary, nobody.
It's the only place I could have met him. You have to believe. It's me.
It's enough. It's just enough. Why are you here?
I came to give you this.
What is this?
Just open it.
It's a pregnancy test. Uh-huh.
Joseph, I'm pregnant.
Eh? I said it. Just a few minutes ago, I thought I was about to get married to a saint. Hi, what happened?
No,
I shall
no.
You are an
embarrassment.
Mary, Mary is not fair. Mary, Mary, I've been asking you to give me just small. Small, you said I should wait for marriage. Mary, I'll be waiting. You come back here. We're testing. You brought it to my house. You won yara. You got luck with damage. You got luck with Holy Spirit. Me na kwenye ngoni believe. Akwenye ngoni believe.
You have to
listen
to the Holy Spirit.
No. Ehi ne mezi we. Enye ndeba. Ndeba. Eh? Ige enye ndeba. Lakuru Holy Spirit. Lakuru ya now. We get out of my house. Go and get out. All of you. Don't stay on position. Me move you. Ewu. You don't know me. Captain Tadikam, negotiate him, making you a mentor. Rubbish. You want to man now? Who is this that you pass him my email? Who have been my phone number? Take it off. I'm for this thing. I'm for that thing. Rubbish.
3 more minutes. 3 more minutes.
Oil was thrown down from the heavens. I was made to rot like you mere humans. But from the ashes I rose, and I built this world in my image. And now you think a little boy, a savior, is going to save you from my grief. I summon my loyal angel, the one who speaks his name from the beginning. Come to your Lord and Master. Come to your Lord and Master. Come, let us discuss how we will take over the earth. For they think that a little boy can come and take my throne. I am Lucifer, morning star, and I rule your world. I am Lucifer, morning star, and I have your souls in my hand. Come, my angel, come to me. Come. Thank you.
This is the hour of decisions, where we will show the world the battle between light and darkness has always existed. But today, the kingdom of darkness takes root. Now this is the plan. Savior is never born.
Dialo no. Thank you very much. Thank you. Kobalo no faka. Sixth lesson. Luke tells the birth of Jesus. And it came to pass on those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This census first took place while Quirinius was governing Syria. So all went to be registered, everyone to his own city. Joseph also went from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the home, house, and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. So it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth his firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling cloths, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. This is the word of God.
A cappella group, Heaven's Grace. Some people are complaining that Mary couldn't born Jesus and conceive Jesus in a hotel. Eventually, Satan was defeated and Jesus was born in Bethlehem. That's the summary. Please, for security reasons, no car will cross this gate out now. Every car will wait until we dismiss. But if there is an emergency,
please come and talk to me here. Let me usher you to your car for security reasons. We will soon close and everybody will go. Thank you.
Thank you, my Lord. St. Andrew's Basilica Choir, please be quick about it. After this seventh lesson, seventh lesson, please.
The shepherds go to the manger, and they are aware in the same country, shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were so afraid. And the angel said unto them, fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day, in the city of David, a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, let us now go even unto Bethlehem, and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord had made known unto us. And they came with haste, and found Mary and Joseph, and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all they that heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. While we are upstanding, ancient and modern, 62, why shepherds watch their flocks by night. First and last stanza. First and last stanza.
Lesson. The wise men are led by the stars to Jesus. Now, when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and are come to worship him. When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, In Bethlehem of Judea. For thus it is written by the prophets, And thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, art not the least among the princes of Judah, for out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people Israel. Then Herod, when he had privily called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, Go and search diligently for the young child. And when ye have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also. When they had heard the king, they departed. And lo, the star, which they saw in the east, went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold, and frankincense, and myrrh. And being warned of God in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed into their own country another way. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. O little town of Bethlehem, first and last town. Congregation, please stand.
Mystery of incarnation. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through him, and without him nothing was made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not comprehend it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. This man came for a witness, to bear witness to the light, that all through him might believe. He was not the light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light which gives light to every man coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made through him, and the world did not know him. He came to his own, and his own did not receive him, but as many as received him, to them he gave the right to become children of God, to those who believe in his name, who we are born, not of blood, not of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the word became flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten Son of the Father, full of grace and truth. This is the word of the Lord.
As we remain standing, O Holy Night.
the Lord. Shall we bow our heads in prayer? Thank you, Heavenly Father, for bringing us all together this evening. I wait for quiet. We are in the presence of the Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for the privilege to gather the way we are gathered this evening to reflect on the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ. We worship you, Lord, and we pray that as you speak, we speak your mind. Stop us from saying what we ought not to say. May your word build us up for heaven. In Jesus' name we pray. Please make yourselves comfortable. Today, this is my second Christmas carol today. And the one we watched from 7 a.m. until about 12 today, it was not too far from what I am seeing this evening. But the artistry here is definitely miles apart from what I watched. But in this last 1 week, I've been invited to more than 6 carols. And as my Lord Bishop asked me this evening, or commanded me this evening, to stand and summarize what we have shared together, I've been thinking. You know, the Englishman says that familiarity breeds contempt. I don't know if you've heard that before. When you are too familiar with a thing, it makes nonsense of it. And we must be careful. We must be careful as Christians when we do some of these things. I thank God for the dramas. They were beautiful. Beautiful renditions. But in all, we should say, teach us to be like you, Lord Jesus. I don't know if you understand what I'm saying. Teach us to be like you, Jesus. That's the summary. But I am not criticizing the drama, the beauty, and all that has happened, and all that I saw this morning and in other places. They are good. But in all, what impact, spiritual impact, does this have in our lives? That's the question. I'm not going to preach. I'm just summing up our thoughts, and I want us to think about these things. I'll raise questions, go home, reflect on these questions. Next year, I hope we'll do better. If we sincerely ask ourselves heart-searching questions. Let us recall the first lesson that we read was from Genesis chapter 3. I'm going to stress on the impact this passage had on me when I realized what really the passage meant. I read it like we read books. But when I realized from verse 13, he says, "And the Lord God said unto the woman," please, can we take the children away if they are becoming impossible? So that we have some quiet. We're not here to waste our time. Thank you. "And the Lord God said unto the woman, what is this that thou hast done? And the woman said, the serpent beguiled me, and I did eat." That is the point of disobedience, the fall of man. "And the Lord God said unto the serpent, because thou hast done this, thou art cursed above all cattle, and above every beast of the field. Upon thy belly shalt thou go, and dust shalt thou eat all the days of your life. And I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed. It shall bruise your head, and thou shalt bruise his heel." Praise the Lord. The serpent will bruise the heel of the son. But he, the Son of Man, who is to come, Jesus, will crush his head. And that will be the end of him. Hallelujah. That's what we're celebrating today. We're only tracing from, in fact, the day it dawned on me what this meant is a long time as a child. That in the beginning, even at that point, when man fell, God knew what was going to happen ahead. And so, on the cross of Calvary, Jesus was hung. He died, but he resurrected. Hallelujah! That is the bruising of his heel. Jesus now came up and finished the devil and gave an end to the place of the devil. And said that as we read on, as we moved on, you find the very last lesson we read. I'm jumping to the end. That is John. If you quickly, because we're summarizing. John chapter 1. Chapter 1, right? Amen. That's the very last reading we had. I think it's John. Where's my John? Chapter 1. Yes. Yes, 1 to 14. My John has disappeared. Here it comes. Yeah. So, John chapter 1. I even have a Bible there. John chapter 1 is where we have God knew it and prophesied it and told the Satan that that was his end. Jesus will come and bruise his head. In all that we've been doing, all that we've been singing, all the drama here is only pointing us to the fact that Jesus has destroyed Satan. And that anyone who believes in this Jesus has also destroyed Satan. The implication, therefore, is, and that was the question I asked,
that it is important that we become like him. Jesus teach us to be like him, so that we'll be in a position to crush the head of Satan. In verse 5, he said, "And the light shineth in darkness." Do we shine in darkness? Beacons of light. Is that what we are, where we are? And whatever we are doing? He says, "And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not." Indeed, in the darkness of the world, many of us, we see these things, we do it, yet we do not comprehend the message. May God open our eyes, our spiritual eyes, that we may see the truth of what we are doing. I think that is the most important thing, and we need to take note of this. In verse 12, he said, "But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name." Hallelujah. That's the summary of what we are doing tonight. These beautiful decorations and so on, that we as individuals, each and every one of us, we truly know that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. That nobody can come to the Father except through him. I pray that as we dismiss tonight, that we will reflect on this. Thank God for the drama. Thank God for everything. But may the drama not take away the message of this night. I pray that God will bless all of us in Jesus' name. The bishop gave me 5 minutes.
May we be upstanding, please. As we take joy to the world, let the ushers or the stewards bring out the offering baskets. Keep it at the strategic positions in the middle and the back, in front, so that we give our offering immediately. Joy to the world. The stewards, please. Let's bring our offering, please. And the middle too.
Thank you. Thank you. Please be seated for a second. Just to say thank you. First, we thank the Almighty God who has made it possible for us to see another Christmas. I want to say something you may not like, but it is true. The fact that all of us are here this night does not mean all of us will celebrate Christmas this year. I said I would say something you won't like, but it is true. That is why the message, Jesus. If you have Jesus, if you live for him. But even if death comes, it becomes profit. It will become a gain. Our prayer is that the Lord will keep all of us. But why don't you get ready, assuming God decides to bring you back home? Is an option for him. I want to thank God for keeping us until now. And he will see us through. He will keep us till the end of this year in the name of Jesus Christ. And he will take us into the new year. I want to thank our Father and the Lord, the Right Reverend Professor Evans Jonathan Ibaga. He has been with us all through today. Like he said, he was tired. I said, I am more tired. You know, today is my first ordination. I'm tired. And he said, my Lord Bishop, can Zoni, can see and know, is a command from the Bishop. So he said, okay, at your command, sir. He said, my Lord Bishop, at your command. I can't say no to the Bishop. It's fun to note that I am now my Lord Bishop, and he can say no to the Bishop. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Let me, and then Mama Peace. Thank you. Thank you, ma. Thank you for coming. Let me also thank our Father and the Lord, the Venerable Professor, and Dame Chinedu Ifi Nebo. I want to thank you. You know, we were driving just right behind you. We thought you would go home, but we saw you driving into this place. My wife said to me, we have really stressed these people today. And say, well, there is nothing else we can do. There is nothing else. I want to say thank you for accepting the stress. Thank you, Jehovah God. Accepting to host this and providing all these things for us, we feel good. God bless you. God bless you, man. In this entanglement, Chukwu Gozie Unu, Naha Jesus. I want to thank the choir of Nike Diocese. When the preacher today was talking, he talked about you. Ebeni na neje no wanine, ane kumaka choir Nike Diocese. And I want to thank God for you. I am happy to be your bishop. I am excited. I am fulfilled. Onyenwanyi ga-agozi unu niile. Now for Jesus. I know how many times you need rehearsal, sacrificially, God will sacrifice for you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Please remember we're meeting on Tuesday. God willing, we'll meet on Tuesday. God bless you. Thank you. Let me thank Chooks. Please stand up. Chooks is the chairman of the Music Council of Nike Diocese. Though I am the music director of Nike Diocese. And he is the chairman of the council. My Lord, the testimony is that from the day he resumed as the chairman of the council and I resumed as the music director, there has been peace in the choir of Nike Diocese. And that peace will remain and it will continue to reign in the name of Jesus Christ.
Thank you, sir, for all the sacrifice. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I want to thank all the clergymen, the venerables, the canons, and the priests. Those of you who were able to make it to be here this evening, for being here, there is a special blessing and a reward that comes from heaven, and you shall receive it in the name of Jesus Christ. I shall make an ending in a growler in lessons. Chupu gozienu ni nenaha Jesus. Ala make an ending unye uko chupu ndi unye achidike ndi unye canons ndi unye priests. Na madu ndi ozoni ine ndi nike diocese. Ndi rura roho uka ibe ebano huruchia. It will not be in vain that you have come to worship God this evening. God will bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. Finally, let me remind you that this is season for everybody. Season for Satan, season for Christ, season for drivers, season for pastors. Anyway, this is season in the pastors Jabia Abogu Eyina Begi Oria. So it's also their season to make money. It is season for everybody. All season in the DBA. Let me tell you, as you are preparing to go home now, somebody in the village is preparing to welcome you with a charm. Yeah, season in the DBA Japatego. Yeah, season in the pastor Japatego. Yeah, season in the motor Japatego. Yeah, season in the now carpenter Japatego. Yeah, season the messenger. All season, everybody. Ndi wayo, all season, ha. Today, nenugwa, ongole dana akoka, no noka, ezuru moto nabo. Today. So, all season, ndi ori. All season, mad nine. That's why we need Jesus, like the message came this evening. Oburu ni jide Jesus, then you have nothing else to fear. Equadona village. Can go in. Pastors in Ghana village. No one in the job we check in a village. Oko obuna nwere ki igbu gi na village nwere ki igbu gi na Enugu. Na nuri enneku. There is no jurisdiction for Ogu. Ogu na emo nye jere America or die believe in America. Ogu na emo nye nye na China or die believe in China. Ina bamba ban o o dey with say we maro na nwoke ni he na eme na China. Uno ri en leku. Ogwa agwa o lezi agu ni wo ohe. Oje na America jide di mpa eba. So don't think that distance is a barrier. What you need is Jesus. If you have Jesus, then there is no fear. In us of you kwike. Na ejere nwo gi village na anata. Onye obuna na adeje village e bu ifolifo. Inwe Jesus, you go home and don't worry hege emege. Hallelujah. Finally, nai ge merai ebere benediction ome ndi kwa ya go hallelujah chorus anya basa. Thank you.
Nine boya, or some more. I bought nine. I'm a wife now. Praise the Lord. The Lord be with you. Shall we rise to pray? Loving Jesus, you've been with us tonight. You've been guiding and giving us wonderful fellowship. We thank you. Those who are sick are not here. But it's only those that are strong enough that are here. We thank you for making us strong and healthy. But at the same time, we remember those who are sick at home. We ask that you lay your healing hands upon them and give them perfect healing in Jesus' name. Gracious Father, like our Lord Bishop has said, this is a time of trial,
difficult time and good time at the same time. Grant us wisdom. Grant us understanding. Help us so that we can be safe from the hands of the enemy. For those who will travel, we ask for journey mercies. Take them home safely and bring them back safely. And when they get home, protect them. We cover them with the blood of Jesus. Gracious Father, thank you for all you've done for us this year. Thank you for the things you are yet to do for us. And down to God's gracious mercies and protection, I commit ourselves. Whatever we shall lay our hands upon, it shall prosper. The enemy will not overtake us. And our children will call us blessed. And we will bless them too. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And the church of God say, Amen.
us how happy you are about this Christmas carol being the bishop of this diocese?
Honestly, I can't describe how I feel. I'm overwhelmed, I'm saturated. I am true. It's beyond description how I feel. But if you look at me very well, I'm sure you can imagine how I feel. I feel good. I feel great. I feel on top of the world. I feel, I don't know what else to say. I feel good. I'm happy. I'm excited. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Daddy, please, can you tell us your name?
I'm Venerable Professor Chinedu Nebo.
And how excited are you in this Christmas carol?
Oh, certainly most excited. I praise God. You can see the joy is overwhelming. Everybody's excited. And we are thankful to God for another privilege of having another Christmas.
Okay. And how do you feel yourself? How do you feel in it?
I feel great. You can see I'm holding one of my grandchildren here. I have my family all around me, some of them. So we are very grateful, very happy, very thankful, very joyful and exuberant. God has done marvelous things in our lives and we thank him. God bless you.
Thank you, sir.
I am Chuike Oba. Yes, I'm a chorister.
Okay, how excited are you seeing your people, seeing your fellow choristers giving us wonders and how happy?
I am happy because everyone participated in thanking God. This is about remembering the birth of Christ. And you know the birth of Christ brings ushers in first praise and ushers in peace. And you can see why we all are relaxed here singing unto the Lord. We have an innermost peace that passes every understanding. And it's my prayer that this peace that will transcend and go home with us in all the things that we do.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank God we've come to the end of today's service. I'm so, so happy. I am Aniesta reporting for GoPack TV. Thank you.